Hello guys, and welcome to C programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the basic structure of C programming language, and we discussed about six sections of basic structure of C programming language. As I said in the previous tutorial, today we'll take one programming example which contains all the section, and I'll explain it again. So here we can see the example program. And this is the first section, which is called as documentation section. As I said, in the documentation section, you'll get all the information about the program, like program name, author, when it is created, when it is modified, something like that. Okay, this is the first section. And as I said, all the informations are commented. That is, these are ignored during the compilation process, and here we can see the comment symbol. This is the multi-line comment. Okay, so this is the first section, and next here we can see hash include stdio.h. Second section is link section. And this is the header file, stdio.h, standard input output header file. This is responsible for input and output function. That is, input and output functions are defined in this header file. Here we are telling the compiler to link the input output function to this header file. And this is the third section, which is called as definition section, where you can define the symbolic constant. And this is the syntax, that is hash define. Here the name, which should be in the capital letter, and here the value. Alright. And next section will be global declaration section. And here we can see the global variable called as total. And here it is initialized with the value 0. Okay, this is the global variable total. Next, here we can see int add, int a, int b. Here this is the user defined function declaration. That is, we are telling that we are using user defined function. So this is its declaration. So we'll discuss how to declare and how to define user defined function in the upcoming tutorials. For now, just remember that if we are using user defined function, then you can declare it here. And next we can see int main. So this is the main section. As I said, every C program contains this main section. And in the main section, there will be two part, right? One is the declaration part and another one is the execution part. And here, this is the declaration part, where we are declaring two local variables, A and B. And next, this will be the execution part. As I said, execution part should contain at least one statement. And next, and here we can see an open curly brace and closed curly brace. Here actually execution start from this curly brace and ends here. Okay, so execution of the program starts from this curly brace and ends here. Okay, this is about the main section. And at last, here we can see user defined function. This is the sub program section, where you can define user defined function, and your program can contain more than one user defined function. So this is the whole program, and it contains every section. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. I'll meet you next class. Till then, take care.